the kindreds of the Urani-Surtr Regulates prize stoicism, self-reliance, and inflexible determination, no matter the odds of success. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint a Hearthkin warrior to a battle-ready standard in the scheme of the Urani-Surtr Regulates. Now, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and to do this, we've chosen to use grey sear. After that, we'll begin our base coats, starting off with ORRUK flesh for the undersuit, then WAAAGH flesh for the armour plates, ABADDON black for the black areas, and MOURNFANG brown for those brown leather areas. So let's get some ORRUK flesh onto the palette here. Now add some water to thin it down a bit. Then roll your brush up to a nice point, and we're going to be applying that all over that undersuit. You'll want to build this up with a couple of thin layers. Next, we're using WAAAGH flesh to pick out the armour panels. Again, you'll want to build this up with a couple of thin layers on the model, and I'm using a small base brush for this. Once that's done, we're going to use ABADDON black to pick out some areas of the boots. We're also going to use this for some parts of the backpack. Don't forget to do the knee pads too. With all the black areas picked out, we're now going to use MOURNFANG brown on the brown leather areas. With the first few base coats done, we're now going to move on to some others. So we're going to start off with MECHANICUS standard grey for the gun casing, then LEADBELCHER for the metallics, followed by RAKARTH flesh for the visor, and then SKRAG brown for some smaller details. So let's get some MECHANICUS standard grey onto the palette here. Again, I'm sticking with a small base brush for this. Going to add some water there, just to thin it down a little bit. Then we're just going to pick out that gun casing. Be as neat as you can, but if you do make any mistakes, don't worry, you can always tidy back up after. Next, we're going to use LEADBELCHER to pick out the metallic details. This is things like the gun casing, some parts of the backpack, any metallic studs, and also the handle on the knife. With all the metallics picked out, we're now going to use RAKARTH flesh on the visor. Once that's dry, we're going to use SKRAG brown to pick out some of the other details. This includes this part of the visor, these screens here, also the lamp here, and these buttons here. With all the base coats done, we can now move on to some shades and contrast. So we're going to start off with Basilicanum Grey, thinned down with contrast medium, and this will be a recessed shade for those armour panels. Then we'll use KROAK Green for the undersuit, AGRAX EARTHSHADE for the brown areas, then it will be Imperial Fist for the blade, followed by some final details using FUEGAN Orange. So let's get two parts contrast medium onto the palette here. Rinse off the brush, make sure to dry it off as well. Then one part Basilicanum Grey and mix that together there. Now, making sure that there's not too much on my brush and making sure I've got a nice point on that brush there, we're going to be applying that into the recesses of the armour panels. We're doing this to create some depth without tinting the overall shade of the armour. Be as neat as you can, but you can always tidy back up with that base coat if you need to. We're also going to be applying this over the metallics as well as the black and grey areas. Next, we're going to apply KROAK Green all over that undersuit. Next, we're using AGRAX EARTHSHADE on all those brown areas. This is also going to go on the visor and the lighter brown details we picked out earlier. Next, we're going to move on to the blade, and for this, we're going to start off with a coat of Imperial Fist. Next, we're going to take some FUEGAN Orange, and we're going to use this to finish the blade by applying quite a chunky edge highlight to the blade. This will create a gradient on the blade and gives us that nice glowy effect. You might want to do a couple of coats of this. And with that done, we can now move on to the base. So for this, we're going to start off with a coat of Steel Legion Drab, followed by a layer of Ard Coat. After that, we'll be applying AGRELLAN Badland and then a shade of AGRAX Earthshade. So let's get some Steel Legion Drab onto the palette here. Thin it down with a touch of water. Then we're just going to apply that liberally all over the base. I'm using a medium base brush for this as it's quite a large area. The reason for doing this is to avoid any grey showing through the cracks when the technical paint dries. Once that's done, we're going to apply a layer of Ard Coat. Now the reason for doing this is that it helps the technical paint adhere to the base better. Once that's dry, we're going to apply AGRELLAN Badland all over the base. For this, we're using the larger end of the texture tool, and then I'm just going to switch to the smaller end to move it around the feet of the model. You want to leave this for about an hour to dry. However, you could speed up the process with a hairdryer if you use it in short bursts. To finish off the base, we're just going to apply a layer of AGRAX Earthshade over the top. And with that shade done, all that's left to do is paint the rim of the base in a colour that matches the rest of your army. In this case, we've chosen to use Steel Legion Drab. Now our Urani-Surtr Regulates warrior is ready to venture into battle and defend the swathe of foe-haunted territories in the galactic core. So there's just a couple of things to remember when you're painting these miniatures. You can use a hairdryer to speed up the drying process of the technical paint and produce larger cracks. However, when you're doing this, make sure you use it in short bursts to avoid warping or melting the miniature in any way. Also, when you're using shades and contrast, be careful not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control on the miniature. However, if you do find this happening, just clean off your brush and use it to soak up the excess. Well, that's the end of the video. We hope you've enjoyed watching and we hope you have great fun painting your own miniatures. We'll see you in the next one. Bye!